All right, into the heavy of this wall. A bicycle ride. I took a bicycle ride. There was a stench from the homelessness. And what do you do except, wow, parked at the school, you know? I mean, how apropos, getting into philosophy. My mother was, oddly, she wrote it down that she was a naturalist philosopher, meaning philosophy dealing with all things environmental and nature and earthbound in consequence. That was a short. But yeah, here I wanted to just, you know, have a nice little talk about, you know, how she had her her little ridiculously like Christmas ornaments of these workhorses, only horses, workhorses. You know, that was her funny of the situation was workhorses, and she'd hang them on the tree. And then that she never told me this. You know, literally, she didn't have to. She's the kind of person that gave it out through objectivity. It was your introduction to that understanding of brain flow. You know, if you got it, you got it. If you didn't, you didn't. And so as the workhorses are there mounted around the tree, and once a year, you know, the sentiment state of the human animal, there it is, finally relaxing. It is one particular odd moment. And, you know, there in the same self room, you know, is hanging the La Guerre of that terrible Picasso one. But yeah, so she had that contrast there of the little, and then there's this, she even has here. Oh, she left me these. I'm giving these all away, but to the oh my gosh, what do we call it? That twirly thing, you know, that goes round and around. She had that, and it's kind of creepy, you know, the merry-go-round ride. This is the tiniest horse of the group, but yeah, it's just the point of it, you know. You know, it's up to you to make that decision, you know, how far you're going to deeply go into what's hanging on that Christmas tree. You know, it's like, you know, is there something said there? And yeah, she was saying something. So, in the workhorse state, my gosh. Well, they get to relax finally, and it's a creepy moment. I'll say that for sure. It's definitely a creepy moment. People creeping around each other, tiptoeing through their tulips, you know, eggshells and all of that going on. And yet, out here in this day, you know, at this school just down the road, you know, this happy little school, you know, for children, is the terrible state of the disarray of the human factor, of homelessness is right there, you know, parked. And now I'm like, oh my gosh, how are they going to remove the person? How are they going to remove the person? It's a situation where we're talking a serious situation. I've seen certain cases, but this is a really bad one. So, it's not Alan Watts out there parked on the corner making a statement that he has too much materialism. It's nothing like that. It's really a bad, bad case. So when you have bad cases, what do? You put them, you say, hey, you know, you could have lethal injection today. We will give it to you. You know, it's that bad. That's what I'm looking at down the road. That's what I'm smelling even here as it lurks through the neighborhood. Do you offer lethal injection to these people? You know what I mean? When life is that bad, when life is this terrible, when there is not the philanthropist state of, hey, you're welcome in my house. I mean, it's only right that we offer a way out. I'm not letting that person into my house. right in here, right now, my little situation, they're not invited. And so thusly, it's not really right or fair of me to say, hey, you know, you have to live another day and in your particular experience, terrible. No. I can only say that, hey, go for it, you know. Let's endorse it. You want a way out, you get a way out. That's it. You know. You have a right to die. Yeah, I mean, there's not a huge list of people that want you. It's just the way it goes. It's just not a huge list. And if there's nobody on the list, and it's only just a policeman who shovels you from one area of the world to the other, one spot to the other, of the town, of the city, then what is it? It's it's not a life. That is not a life. You're merely just their particular garbage that they just keep moving around with a broom. You know? It's not a life. So yeah, I believe we have to offer immediate, like in this particular situation, this person has to be offered immediately something, A, to relax the person. Some relaxant, because you don't want a panic state. And the secondary, you have to give them something natural, and I will go straight to cannabis, offer them cannabis, perhaps that will be a natural state moment, and then start going through the list of questions. Well, I mean, what's going on here? You have to go through the list of questions. Do you know anybody? Are you from the America? What's going on? And if there is no answer, good enough, you know, do you want to just end it? You know, all of these have to be endured. They just have to go on. Because it's not fair to the sweeper police who have to keep doing this. It's not fair to the neighborhood hasslers. The hasslers, well, yeah, oh my gosh, it's in front of my house or whatever, you know, that person getting the major hassle. It's not fair to them. And then, okay, so fine, you can go back to the luxury of philosophy and go, well, the school of thought is, what a garbage state the human existence is. Well, I'm tired of that one, you know, that's not it's not helping anything. No, I guess so. We have to offer lethal injections. I know, that's a rough video, huh? Not really like politics today, but that's it.